Hey there, what's up everyone? How are you all today? I hope you are doing well at home. Welcome back to my class. As you all know that periodic assessment test 1 is going to start, right children? So do you know when is the English exam? Yeah, very good. That is on 12th of November 2020. And do you know the syllabus of English? Right, very well. So first lesson, the tale of Benjamin Bunny. Second lesson, the big race. Poem, Hurt No Living Thing. And plus, worksheet 1 and worksheet 2. Page number 1 here and worksheet 2, page number 8. Okay? So, I will be explaining you lesson 1, some of the bits. So let us learn. Please open your textbook and learn with me. So the first lesson is the tale of Benjamin Bunny. Here the story of Benjamin Bunny, right? Okay, so let us see the question answers bit. Answer in brief. So children, I'll be giving you as multiple choice questions, okay? If I ask you, suppose, who was little Benjamin visiting? I'll give you some options, three options, and you have to select the correct one. Okay? Now let's start. First one, who was little Benjamin Benny visiting? Where did they live? So answer is, little Benjamin was visiting his cousins. He was visiting cousins. So what are the cousins' name here? Flopsy, Mopsy, Cottontail and Peter. Where do they live? They lived in the wood at the back of Mr. McGregor's garden. Okay, please learn this question answer. Next, what did Mrs. Rabbit tell the little bunnies? That told the little bunnies that they may go into the fields down the lane, but don't go into Mr. McGregor's garden. Okay, next question. What was Peter wearing when little Benjamin found him? Peter was wearing red cotton pocket handkerchief. Okay, now next question. Why did little Benjamin and Peter hide under a basket? Little Benjamin and Peter hid under a basket because they were frightened by seeing a large cat sitting over there. Okay, next. When did old Mr. Benjamin Bunny come looking for his son? Old Mr. Benjamin Bunny came looking for his son in the evening. Okay, so well, this bit you have to learn, children. Okay, these two bits no need to learn. Then comes grammar part. Noun consists of two types. As per your syllabus, here is two nouns. So one is common noun and the other is proper noun. Children, do you know common noun? Yes, it is a general name of person, place, animal or thing, and it will be in a small letter. As you can see here, rabbit, R, small letter, coat, C, small letter, garden. Just I have said the general name of the place, garden. Which, what is the name of the garden? I have not mentioned. Okay, so just garden I have said. So G, small. So this comes under common noun. Boy, what is the name of a boy? I have not mentioned here. Just I said the general name, boy. So B, small letter, and it comes under common noun. School, under, comes under common noun. Next comes proper noun. It is a special name, particular name of a person, place, animal or thing. And it always begins with a capital letter. Here, Peter, name of the rabbit I have said. So Peter, P capital, right? Benjamin Bunny, name of a rabbit, right? Benjamin, I have said, B capital. Here, Pluto pencil, name of the pencil is Pluto, okay? Mumbai, name of a city, particular name of a city I have said. So it is a capital and it comes under proper noun. Okay children, did you understand? So let us revise. Who was little Benjamin visiting? Yeah, his cousins, four cousins, Flopsy, Mopsy, Cottontail and Peter. And who is the naughtiest rabbit here? Peter is the naughtiest rabbit. Okay. And what did Mrs. Rabbit tell the little bunnies? That they should not go to the garden. Okay. Now, let us see the next common noun and proper noun. Underline you have to do. Okay. The house of Mr. Sharma. Yeah, Mr. Sharma is name of a person. So, it comes proper noun and you have to circle. Okay, children. Then common noun, nothing but house. Name of a house. I don't know. Just I said house. So, you have to underline. It is common noun. A student. Student is common noun. The name of a student is? I have not mentioned. So, just I said student. Of Miss Shobha. Miss Shobha is a name of a person. Comes proper noun. And it is in capital letter. Right, children? Now, next. The island of Sri Lanka. Island. The name I have not mentioned. So, it is a common noun. You have to underline. The name of a city or country is here Sri Lanka. Proper noun. You have to circle. Next. The map of Australia. Map is the common noun. It is starting with a small letters. And Australia. A capital. It's a proper noun. The animals in the Gir forest. Here the name of the forest is Gir. So it is a proper noun and it is starting with a capital letter. And here animals, just common name. Animals, underline. Sixth is my cousin from America. America, name of country, and it is starting with a capital letter A. So it is a proper noun, you have to circle. Here cousin, the name of a cousin I have not mentioned, just I said cousin. So it's a common noun and you have to underline. Okay, children. Now comes collective noun. One of the type of noun is collective noun. There are three types: common noun, proper noun, and collective noun in your syllabus. So I have explained. Okay, the common noun is nothing but a group of people, animals, or things. Here are the examples: pride of lions, pride of lions, group of lions, team of players. Here, team is a collective noun. Pile of clothes, pile is nothing but collective noun. A bunch of flowers. A bunch is collective noun. Nothing but group of flowers. We will be saying bunch. Okay. Here match the following. A pile of rubbish. A gang of thieves. A gang of thieves. A pack of cards. A pack of cards. A swarm of bees. A swarm of bees. A team of athletes or players, you can say. A team of athletes. Next, a band of singers. A band of singers. So, well, we'll stop till here. You have to learn these bits, whatever I have taught you. Okay? Please go through, revise it 2-3 times. Okay? The next bits I'll be explaining you in the next video. So, till then, take care and keep learning. Bye-bye.